like, subscribe, and share. Please help.
Welcome back, everybody. Hey guys, I just clipped together all of my Friday the 13th NECA Jason Part 7 figure videos that I made over the last couple months, starting with the building of the set and all of that kind of stuff that I did. I originally made that video because everybody was kind of worried that the figure wasn't going to come out, and I kind of made it to try to make everybody feel better, to give them some hope that the figure was coming out, because a lot of people were commenting and getting very upset that the figure wasn't being released and they were really afraid they weren't going to get it. And I just, you know, wanted to make everybody feel like maybe it was still going to come out, which it did. And so I just compiled all of the videos and the footage, everything together in this one long video, including like just stuff where you will see the sets that I built from a distance, and you'll get an idea of how I did what I did with like the underwater sequence with Jason and all of that kind of stuff. And I'll explain it, I'll narrate over it or whatever. So if you guys are just interested in seeing all of this together, this video is going to compile everything I made for NECA's Ultimate Jason Friday the 13th Part 7 A New Blood figure, which is an incredible figure. If you guys are a Friday the 13th fan, you really should get this figure if you can get your hands on it. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoy the video. This is going to be everything, and I'll kind of narrate over some of the stuff you may have already seen, and I'm going to show some of the like behind the scenes stuff that just, so if you guys ever want to do this yourself, it's really easy. I didn't do anything that was very complicated. I don't have the experience making sets and dioramas and all of that, so if I can do it, that means you can do it. And for the underwater sequence, I literally used the brown box that the figure came in, and I did it really quickly, and yeah, it was pretty easy. So if I can do it, you guys can do it. And if you want to build this stuff, I'm going to show you everything that I used for the video pretty much. Anyways, I hope you enjoy the video. Bye. So this is the beginning of the set that I had set up. The base is literally Manhattan mini storage box laid flat. And then those are paper towel rolls that were taped together, stacked on top of each other. And then this was months later, after I got the fake grass that I bought through eBay that's usually used for like train sets, and I got some sand in a jar from Michael's and some fake trees that I ordered again through eBay or whatever, like Christmas tree kind of things. And then I got a bag of like moss from Michael's as well, and then I paper mache'd the trees and painted them brown and black so that, you know, they try to make them look as real as they could. And then this was a briar set that I used that came with the axe and all of that, and the kettle over the fire and the tent. And then I was using the Jason Part 6 figure for the stand-in, just to get an idea of what it would look like when I finally made my YouTube video of the NECA Jason Part 7 figure. And yeah, I really was really happy with the way it was coming. I didn't get a lot of time to work on it later, so it didn't change a whole lot. This is pretty much, when I saw this, I knew with lighting, with the, you know, dim lighting that I was going to use, I figured it would work, except for the backdrop material is black, and it's like kind of like a silvery sparkly look to it, and I knew that wasn't right for this video. I've used it many times before and I absolutely hate it, but luckily I got something for the backdrop, and it's just flat black material and it looks pretty good. And then again, I used the Jason Part 6 figure, and if you see, the in the back was the Friday the 13th Camp Crystal Lake sign that came with NECA's Friday the 13th Crystal Lake accessory pack. So obviously I used that in there as well. This wasn't even originally filmed to be posted on YouTube, it was just filmed for reference. So when the figure actually came out, I would look at the video to remember how I set it up and how I wanted it. And it pretty much stayed the way it is here. It changed a little bit, but not by a lot, and I added a few things, but I'm happy with the way it came out. It looks pretty good on film. I'm not the best cameraman by any means, but I'm still learning. So if you guys want to do this, it's pretty easy to put together. It's just paper towel rolls and a few other things. So after what feels like about a year, which it probably wasn't a year, but it feels like it, I finally got my Friday the 13th Part 7 A New Blood Jason figure. So I'm going to make a video soon. I just wanted to kind of show it a little bit. And I'm going to get to work on doing a video pretty soon. Hold on. Wait. There he is. Finally got him. I'm going to start making the video now. Yay! Okay, so let's look at this figure real quick. There he is. This figure caused so many collectors so much stress. People were freaking out saying that it was going to be canceled and that they were never going to get it. And it's understandable, I get it. But all that negativity and worry gets you nowhere, because eventually these figures do usually come out. So it doesn't do you any good to stress yourself out if it's there right away or not. And I get it. I get it. I get wanting it. But everybody was kind of downing NECA and getting on them about it. But because of the COVID thing, it caused some delays, whether people want to believe that or not. They kept saying it wasn't coming out. Blah, 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 blah. And here he is. He's here. I got mine. So we're going to look at him real quick. I'm actually going to do two videos of this figure, I've decided. I want to do one because I have a whole set for it, but I don't have it set up yet. So I'm going to just kind of do this real quick one over, showing the box and the figure and stuff. And then I'm going to make another video later for myself. And if you guys want to watch that one too, that's great. But I've built a whole set for it and I want to do that. But I want to get this one up right now because there were so many people freaking out about it and not believing that they were going to get it and that it wasn't coming out. And there it is right there. There's a curse in these woods. Jason Voorhees' curse. They say he died as a boy, but he keeps coming back. They can say that again because the studios kept making a lot of frickin' money. Few have seen him and lived. Some have tried to stop him. No one can. He's out there waiting. Of course, Tina was out there to kick his ass too. And, you know, this would have been perfect if NECA would have made Tina, you know, because I mean, I don't know how they would give her any action features like telekinesic shit, but you know what? It would have been cool to have her. Floating Tina. Okay, hold on. I'm going to open this. NECA always has that one little sticker right there on the one side. So I'm going to do that and then I'll come back and edit this real quick. Here he is in the package. There's his head without the mask. That looks really awesome. That is honestly, I think, the best sculpted hockey mask that NECA has done so far. A lot of people don't like the damage to the hockey mask, and I understand that because they think it, you know, it cuts away and you see too much of his face and you see his teeth and his jaw, but I always thought it looked really cool, actually. It never really bothered me. It didn't show that much of his face, but I understand why other people wouldn't like it. I'm not downing their, you know, why they don't like it. But one of the things I didn't like about it, though I thought it looked really cool for the movie, is the damage is supposed to be done with the propeller of the boat. And it was supposed to maybe, you know, it's implied that it was supposed to cut away part of the hockey mask when his neck was sliced by the final girl in Part 6, whose name I can't remember right now. But we all saw him floating at the end of Part 6, and the hockey mask was undamaged by that. So while it looked cool in Part 7 to me, I was very aware that's not what happened to the mask. But the figure looks really cool. I mean, this is the best looking Jason figure to me so far from NECA. Part 3 is my favorite Jason, and it has been for many, 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 many years now. But part seven, I have to say, I've always loved. And he's right up there in my favorite Jasons, though I could never understand why he was so big and bulky like Arnold Schwarzenegger, but you saw all of his bones and stuff. It just kind of didn't make any sense. But it looked cool. And he comes with all of his stuff real quick. Going over this real quick. And then, you know, this knife right here looks like Michael's knife from Halloween. It actually is the best butcher knife I think NECA has ever made, because usually the blades look too small. Michael's blade in Halloween is huge. I mean, it's a huge knife. It looks like it's about 18 inches or something, and they always make it kind of stubby. NECA, I mean. This one looks big. This looks like it would really look good in your, like your part two Michael Myers action figure in his hand. So I might actually use it for that. But there's a lot of cool stuff here. So let's take him out real quick. Okay, this figure is really, really awesome. Look at that. Let's look at the back of his head. If we can get it to focus here. Wow. This figure is amazing. Look at the detail and the pant legs and everything. There's the back. You could always see the spine. In the movie, you see the spine and it looks like it's a latex. You know, it looks like what it is. It looks like a latex application that was probably somehow sewn into the back of the shirt, or it was something that he wore over his, probably something, a piece of latex he wore over his body, over his back and chest and stuff, obviously. Not part of the shirt, but there it is. Again, I'm just doing this video really quick just to show everybody, and then I'm going to make a whole other video because, you know what, I want to. I don't think this mask comes, okay, this, oh, it does. This mask does come off. Ooh. That is so cool. Yeah, the mask comes off. It looks like it's kind of stuck. No, it comes all the way off. Look at that. Well, actually, let's look at it. That is honestly, that is the best sculpted hockey mask NECA has done so far. Again, in part six, the propeller does not cut that away, but it's, you know, you're supposed to assume that this damage was done by the propeller at the end of part six. But we know that didn't really actually happen. But Jason always looked different in every movie too, so I guess, you know, when they did these little changes, you just kind of accept them. There's his face. He looks pretty good. This is an awesome Jason figure. It really is. They included, when they did part seven, they included all of the damage that had been done to him through all of the other movies. Like, there's the machete from Tommy that went through to his eye. The, oh, it's getting out of focus. The axe split is there. Yeah, it looks good. I think he kind of looks like the face, if he wasn't a zombie looking, like a skeleton looking thing, something from Return of the Living Dead or something, he would probably look, I guess, more like Jason from, I don't know, maybe he's more like Ted White's Jason from the final chapter, maybe. You know, the last one. Yeah. So let's look at this head real quick. And there he is. That's his surprise face when his mask splits and he's like, what the fuck? How is this girl doing this crap? That is that face that he makes. And again, there's all the damage from the axe, from the machete that sliced his head by Tommy.
Okay, so for the hockey mask, there's a little hole in the back of his head, just so you guys see that. And that is where this little... That there is supposed to go into the little hole. It's the hockey mask that's split in two. So let's do that. So you put that in there, and there you go. It's like, what the hell's going on? How is she doing this crap? What the hell? I don't think he was scared of Tina, but I think she like irritated the hell out of him. And he couldn't figure out how she was doing it because, you know, while he's smart in some ways, he's definitely not the brightest crayon in the box in other ways.
This really does look really, really cool though. I think I want to display him just like this. I wish I had a Tina figure. Maybe NECA will make a Tina figure to go with this. That would be really awesome.
Okay, so I got him back in the box. And we're going to look at the weapons, but again, I'm going to have the other video, so I will show the weapons off in the other video, but I'm going to just show these. I'm not going to show him holding them in this section because I'm going to do that in the other video. But this is the, I don't know even what you call this. It's like a hedge trimmer kind of thing. I guess that's what it is. It's a hedger. If somebody knows, I'm sure they're gonna leave it in the comment like they always do, because I really don't know. I think it's just like a hedger. It's for, you know, trimming limbs on trees and that kind of thing. Yeah, this is really a very, 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 there's the gas tank. This is like a really detailed piece. Very cool. Actually, let me see if I can show you this. Let's do this. And then does this turn the wheel? It sure does. It spins. And there's the detail. That is very, very detailed. Man, I'm glad I got this figure. I mean, it is just such an awesome figure. I mean, I'm having a hard time picking which NECA figure I think is the best figure this year because they've all been so good so far. There's been so many different good ones. And then there's still the Nightmare Demons and the from American Werewolf in London and the Kessler Wolf. So, I mean, this is just an unbelievable year for figures from NECA. Oh, and not to mention the Halloween 2 two-pack with Dr. Loomis and Michael Myers. And that is, I have no clue what the hell that is. It's like a machete on a stick. Again, somebody can tell me what this is. Because I really don't know what you would use this for. I guess it's for like another gardening kind of tool kind of thing or something of chopping down. I don't really know. For chopping people's fucking heads off, I guess. I don't know what the hell it's for. It was made for Jason, I guess. Who knows? And there is this sickle. And he has this sickle, which he kills the girl who gets all dressed up that wears the glasses and she loses her contacts or whatever. Yeah. Okay, so that's that one. Very cool. And then there is just an axe, but it looks good. And there is the spike. Let me see, I'm gonna show this. This is the spike that is supposed to hold the tent into the ground. It's a metal spike that they were using to set their tent up with, and Jason uses it and kills somebody's brother in there. And there is the knife. It's the Michael Myers butcher knife. It's, yeah, looks good. It's probably the best butcher knife that NECA's made so far. Looks pretty good. And of course, we have the machete. What would Jason be? Any Jason action figure be without his machete? There it is. And those are his gripping hands. So those are the interchangeable hands that it comes with. Hold on, I'll flip them around. And there they are. The interchangeable hands. And this is the last look for the NECA Friday the 13th Part 7 Jason figure. We're going to give him a one over real quick. I always like to pan up and down just to kind of give you guys a look at the sculpting. Like in the shoes and the pants, the bones. You guys really should get this one. Don't let this one pass you by, because this is the coolest Jason figure to date. Anyways, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.
Okay, so when I first planned this video, I always intended to show Jason underwater, and this is the set I built inside of the box that Jason came in. You can see me struggling with a little desk lamp that has some blue cellophane wrapped around it, which is probably a fire hazard. But that's what I use to shine through here at the top. And below, you see a Christmas light, a blue Christmas light right there. That was for the blue effect for what was supposed to be like maybe at nighttime, as you see, you know, Jason underwater at night. So I put the blue Christmas lights at the bottom. But you can see the set that I built, and all of the cellophane that's inside and above it, and then at one point it's filmed in front, and then I removed it to get some shots with it removed as well. But you can see the desk lamp shining there through the top of the cellophane that's over the top of the box where I ripped off the lids of the box that the figure actually came in, the brown box it was shipped in. I turned into a little black box theater kind of thing. And
where did that go?
You can see it here. There it is. It's a blue tablecloth and blue cellophane. And you can see the cellophane right here in front. And I filmed through it so it would give it the water effect. And you can kind of see the blue cellophane on the top as well. So some of it was filmed with that in the front, and then it was taken away and some shots were filmed without it. But just to give the illusion, it was underwater. I didn't submerge it in water. I didn't put it in a fish tank or something. I just literally used the box, some blue cellophane inside and outside, a blue tablecloth that was real thin, plastic underneath to give it more of a deep blue effect, and the light, the desk lamp shining from above as you see, and then I wrapped some blue cellophane around the end of the desk lamp, which again was probably a fire hazard. I'm trying to see what this is here. It's just, yeah, that's the lamp, the desk lamp with the blue cellophane in front of it. Otherwise, if I didn't use that, it was too bright. So I could change and kind of control the lighting that, you know, how I wanted the viewer to see. And you can see the Christmas lights at one point were above as well. The blue Christmas lights were shining above for different lighting effects. Sometimes they were above, then I laid them on the bottom. Here they were shining from above behind him. So yeah, I love the way this looks. I had no experience doing this. This is just me experimenting, trying to figure it out. And then I bought some sand from Michael's, and that is the sand that's supposed to be the bottom of the lake, of Crystal Lake. And that chain and all of that is from the Friday the 13th accessory pack, Crystal Lake accessory pack from NECA that I think is still available. And I really originally always kind of planned on posing him on a desk like this and just kind of leaving him like this, but I think I'm going to pose him in different ways at different times. But I love the lighting effect, and you guys can do this. It's really easy to do. Just be careful not to you know, catch your house on fire with the cellophane and the lamp. But here it is. It's just a box that I rigged up. You can see the cellophane on the top. And inside of the box, the little fake plant inside, the little blue Christmas lights on the bottom. So it gave a different effect. And yeah, and there it is. It's on my living room floor with, yeah, that was it. It literally is a little theater that I built out of the box it was shipped in. Yeah, so you guys can do this too. It's not hard. It was thrown together so quickly, as you can kind of tell by looking at it. And here is the set that I built for the Crystal Lake set for the rest of the above ground sequence for the rest of the video. It's a black box theater. I didn't get anything for a backdrop. I just got some black material since it was supposed to be nighttime and I don't have a lot of space. So it's not very big. It's sizable, but for a New York apartment, I would have loved to have made it bigger, but for a New York apartment, I don't have that kind of space, you know, that I wanted to have. Also, the yellow sleeping bag is from Mattel. It's a Barbie sleeping bag that has on the other side is Tweety Bird. I'm not kidding. It's the only yellow sleeping bag I could find. But yeah, I built this and I didn't have a lot of room. So, you know, if you got more room, you can make the lake bigger and longer, which would have been really ideal for this. I would have loved to have had more room to have more scope, but it just turned out to be a small black box kind of theater, you know, stage. The trees are just paper towel rolls that were two stacked on top of each other, taped, and then paper macheed with butcher paper, brown butcher paper, and then crinkled up, and then painted black as the base, and then brown over it so that, you know, it would look a little more realistic. And then I bought a thing of sand from Michael's, and that was used for the sand on the beach, and yeah. So you guys can make this too if you want to. I just want to show you in this part of this video everything that was used in my NECA Jason Part 7 figure video. Of course, as you know, Jason himself was used, of course. That's the reason for the video. And then I used NECA's Friday the 13th Camp Crystal Lake accessory set, which most of you are familiar with if you're watching this video. That comes with the rock with the chain to make it appear as if he's floating and, you know, the chain's around his neck and all of that. So I utilize that. Then there's the Crystal Lake sign right there. And there's that again. And then there's the boat dock from Friday the 13th Part 3 with the light above him. I utilize that. You can still get these. I mean, of course, the Jason Part 3 is brand new, so of course you can get him. And like at Target, Walmart, or from Big Bad Toy Store, Nightmare Toys, Amok Time, look for your favorite online toy dealer, your independent toy seller. That's who I would go with first, just, you know, to support them. But you can get it from Target, so if you want to support them, you can get it from Target and Walmart probably as well. A lot of people asked me about the tent and the picnic table. I had a few people ask me about that, you know, because I did a preview video, you know, just to kind of make something, because everybody was so worried the figure wasn't coming and it had been months and months and months, and I wanted maybe, you know, people to feel a little bit better about the figure and all that. So I made kind of a video of me making the set that I was working on for this video that I made. Anyways, so a lot of people asked that, so I'm going to show what that was to you guys and reveal that. So this is the set. It's made by Breyer. They're known for their horses that they make right here. And I got this on eBay when, way a long time ago, when NECA's original Jason Part 3 retro cloth figure came out. They released Freddy and Jason. That was their first two 8-inch retro cloth figures. And I was gonna make a diorama for that figure and use some Mego figures as to sit around the camp with Jason, you know, somewhere in the background or something. And it, you know, I was going to make this diorama, and it went in storage. I forgot all about it. And when this was coming out, I thought, I'm going to make a video of the Part 7 Jason. And then I remembered that I had this. So So that is what I utilized for the tent. And yeah, so I will show, yeah, it comes with all of that stuff there. And I have to say, I don't see this come up very often. I got it on eBay. It was a bidding war. This is years and years and years ago. Whenever that Jason figure came out, that's when I got this. And it was a real bidding war on eBay, and I have not seen it come up. And I don't think I got this for very cheap when I got it. But again, I honestly can't remember. It's been years ago, but I had people asking, and I didn't want to reveal what it was to everybody because I hadn't made my video yet. You know, and if I hadn't got my Jason video, if somebody else went and did the exact same thing that I had shown I was doing in my construction of my set for this video, I didn't want somebody to get it and then do the same exact thing that I was going to do. And then, you know, I kind of shot myself in the foot. But now I will reveal it. And if you want to make your videos, go for it. Good luck if you can find it. It's right there. And for Tina, the Tina figure, since there is no Tina figure and it's doubtful NECA will make one, I was desperate and I did not want to do this, but I opened my Lauren Dern Jurassic Park. I literally was in the middle of filming and I wanted a Tina figure. I'm like, how am I going to do this? And I had this and I ripped it open. I ripped it open so it's no longer meant, but she was my Tina figure and I only showed her from behind. And I know you guys what Tina's wearing in part 7, but it's the only female figure that I could find that would be comparable. Look at this. How sad is that? It's the only figure I could find that would be comparable to show from a back view of Tina kicking Jason's ass with her psychic telekinesic powers. So yeah, somebody asked me one of my videos or one of the Jason videos, who are the victims? Tina's not a victim. She kicks his ass, you guys. So she's not one of the victims in the video because she kicks his ass. Okay, and the other figure is Jacob from Twilight New Moon in Series 2 NECA. I bought him because I have Pinhead and the Cenobites with the little diorama, the little scene that NECA made for those figures. And I have him as my fill-in for, my stand-in for Frank. So literally, when you see him on my shelf with the Cenobites, his back is facing Pinhead, like he's looking at Pinhead, and then the block is in front of him. So it looks like it's Frank in front of the Cenobites. So that's why I have this figure. I'm not a big Twilight fan, so sorry to those who love that series. I think I've only seen the first one, and that was more than I ever needed to see for me. But this figure was purchased used loose, so I would have a Frank figure in my on my shelf. So for me, it's just Frank, but I know who the actor is. I can't remember his name. And I know he's from the Twilight series, so if you want this figure, I think you can still get him on eBay. At one point, Christine was going to be in the background, in the distance from kind of like the trees would be in front of it, and it would be an illusion. It would look like it was in the distance, but because the car is smaller and not in scale with the figures, it would make it look like it was a little further away. But unfortunately, I live in New York City, and I have a very tiny apartment, so I can't do huge dioramas. I don't have the room. If I did, the water in my video would have been much bigger, and there would have been more land as well. But because I live in New York and I don't have the space to build something that big, you know, I wasn't able to use the car because I didn't have enough land to put her in the background. Otherwise, Christine was going to be in my Jason video in the background, which I think would have been kind of cool, but it didn't fit. Okay, so if you're wanting this stuff, Camp Crystal Lake accessory set, Friday the 13th, Jason Part 7, Jacob from New Moon Series 2 NECA, Amber Collection, Ellie Sattler, Dr. Ellie Sattler, and the Briar Camp Set. So that's everything that I used in this video pretty much. Anyways, that's it. Thank you.
wish I could bring it back.
Is anybody there? Is that you, Bella? Hello? I thought I heard a weird sound, so I walked 2 miles to find out what it was. Is that you, Bella? Bella? Wonder what it was. Hey, Bella! Is that you? Guess not.
Why do I feel like somebody's watching me?
I can't wait for this night to be over.
Well, that's it for this video. Please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye.
He's completely mad. Toys in the attic he has.
Completely mad.